Hello everyone, this is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to deploying MinIO operator on Kubernetes using Helm. This is the guided exercise portion of the video where we are going to walk through the very first section that we discussed about downloading the MinIO operator Helm chart and customizing the values file and actually deploying the operator using Helm. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to download the appropriate Helm chart to our system. And in this case, we're going to be using the gzipped operator because we need to extract the values file that's associated with this because we're actually going to customize that before we do our deployment. So we're going to run this curl command and links in the description to all of the docs that describe this in detail. I recommend that you obviously follow along with those because I'm not sure when you're going to be watching this. And so the versions or instructions may have changed. So now that we've downloaded that, the next thing we need to do is to unzip that. We'll do that with this command right here, tar minus zxf, and then the name of the operator file. And this is going to unpack that into the operator directory. And so we can see that there's a operator directory right here. The next thing we're going to do is that within that operator directory, if I take a look at that, we can see that there is a values.yaml file. So that is the default values.yaml file. And we want to copy that out and create a brand new values file that we will reference when we're deploying this because we're going to actually customize this values file. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll run this command, which is cp for copy in Linux. And then we're going to copy the operator values file to the operator custom operator values YAML file. And now that we've done that, we can actually modify this new custom file that we've created. So we'll go ahead and use nano to do that. So you can use whatever editor that you want, obviously, but make sure that you are respecting the YAML syntax and the spacing in YAML because that will come back to bite you if you do not pay attention to that. So what we need to update here is that we will need to change the operator runtime. So that's the first thing in the environmental variables. And we need to uncomment this. And the value for this, in our case, is going to be Rancher. Now, I gave you a link in the description, and I mentioned this before, but there are a number of different environmental variables that you'll need to choose depending on the system you're running on. In this case, we're running on K3S, and so we need to specify Rancher as the overarching system that's used here so that the operator can function with it correctly. The next thing we're going to modify here is the replica count. Now, we're running a single node Rancher deployment on a single host, and so we just want one replica so as we don't overwhelm the system. This is not meant to be highly available, but obviously in highly available systems, you'll want to run more than one copy of the operator itself. The next thing that we're going to modify here is the ingress. So I have a DNS name already pointed to this. And if you do not have a DNS name, then you'll probably want to follow along with the node port method. But in this case, I'm going to go ahead and enable ingress by changing enable to true. And my ingress class name is Nginx. Now yours might be different, so you'll need to go check your ingress classes in Kubernetes to understand what options you have. You can have more than one ingress installed, so you'll need to understand which one you should be using. But in my case, mine is just called Nginx, and it's using ingress Nginx. And then the last piece is, what is the name of the endpoint that we're using here? So my DNS name that is actually pointed at this cluster is minioconsole1.dsodemo.org. So that's actually going to automatically create the ingress necessary for me to access this from outside. And I've already pointed my DNS at this host. So once we get this up and running, we should be able to access our MinIO operator console using this address. That's all we need to modify here. So we'll go ahead and exit out of this. And now we've written that to the system. Next, we can actually go ahead and install the operator using that values file. So the command here will be helm install. And then we'll choose the namespace MinIO operator. We'll go ahead and say create the namespace because it likely doesn't exist already. And this is arbitrary, but we're just going to call it MinIO operator because it's the proper description for it. We're choosing the operator 5.0.6 gzipped file that we downloaded from the local system just so that we can deploy it without having to pull down from the web. And we're also specifying that we're going to use that custom operator values file that we just created in order to do this deployment. So you can see that that was done pretty quickly. And now let's go and check the status of our deployment. So kubectl get all minus n. So we can see that there are a number of different things deployed here for this particular application. So we can see that there's a couple of pods. We can see that there's a number of services. There's some deployments and there's some replica sets as well. So it looks like everything is up and running and healthy. And this should be a good base install for the MinIO operator. So the next piece is that there may be some additional YAML that you need to create from existing things in the system already or from scratch that makes your deployment work for you. So if you do not have a domain name and you want to use a node port, you can actually copy out one of the services that are in here and go and modify that. So if you run this command, which will be kubectl get service console, and this is assuming that you haven't changed the namespace. So in my case, the namespace is MinIO operator, and you're going to output it as YAML to a file called service.yaml. So let's go take a look at that. So you can see here that we've copied a service that was already running, and all we want to do is update this file. So let's go ahead and do that. So this file contains all the details of an existing running service. So we need to tweak this file in order to not have it collide with that other service or not overwrite that service, but rather to be able to actually deploy this service and modify it so that it can actually allow for an ingress into our system. The first thing that we need to do is we need to remove the cluster IP and cluster IPs because we're not overwriting that service. We're creating a brand new service next to that service. So we don't want to overwrite the existing console, but rather we want to create a new service that essentially points to the same pods. So we're going to remove the cluster IP and cluster IPs from this because it's just going to create a new one when we actually deploy this. The next thing we want to do down here under type is change the cluster IP to node port. And then the next thing that we want to do is to add the type of node port, or sorry, the node port that we want to use to the port definition. So in this case, we want to use port 30,000, which is within the ephemeral range or node port range of most Kubernetes clusters. And that will be the permanent access point that we can use to get to our MinIO console via the web browser. Let's see, is there anything else that we need to modify here? So we will call this the node port console as well. So we're actually going to update the name as well, just so it has a different name and we can easily understand that that's separate from the other existing one that was deployed by the operator. So that's really all that you need to modify. We can go ahead and save this file. And now we could go ahead and apply this file. I'm not going to because I'm actually going to use the DNS name, but you could go ahead and apply that file and get to your cluster using port 30,000. Again, this requires some knowledge of Kubernetes. And so we may have gotten in the weeds a bit there, but hopefully that made enough sense for you to be able to dig in and understand that. The next file that you may want to create and modify is the operator configuration. So let's go ahead and run this command. We'll actually get the deployment MinIO operator and output that as YAML, and we'll call that file operator.yaml. And then let's go in and edit that. So this is a deployment configuration, and you'll note here that because I updated my values file, the replicas are already one. But if you wanted to change this or you forgot to update this in your values file, you could actually go ahead and come in here and modify this to suit your needs and apply this file to your system using kubectl apply minus f in the name of this file. And you would be able to then update a lot of these details. You can see there's lots of other things in here that you could update to modify the exact deployment for the MinIO operator. So again, because I've modified my operator values file already, I don't need to go and do this, but just in case you didn't and you want to do this after the fact, you can actually do it this way. The last thing is that we may need to create a secret, but if we do kubectl get secret minus n, we can see that there's already a console SA secret here. So you may want to run that again and generate a new secret or update that secret. And the way that you would do that is that you would take this code right here and put it into a file, probably something called console secret, and be able to do that. Now, again, don't get caught up trying to copy this off the screen. Links in the description to the exact documentation that talks about this, and you'll be able to copy it from there in order to create this. But this is already created for us. You don't need to do this in order to access your cluster right now. Let's do one more check of our cluster. So we'll do get all on that namespace and make sure that everything looks like it's up and running and happy, and it appears to be. So now the last piece before we can actually access the UI is to be able to get the token. The JWT token or Java Web token that you will use to access this is actually stored in that secret we just talked about. So this is the command. Again, don't panic. Links in the description. This command is in that link in the MinIO docs. But essentially what we're doing here is defining a variable that says the SA token equals this kubectl command. So we're going to go kubectl minus n, the MinIO operator namespace, get the secret named console SA secret, and then we're going to basically grab that JSON path that has a token in it and decode that JSON. Now, if that sounded like Greek to you, you might want to back up and look at our just enough Kubernetes to be dangerous portion of this course. But essentially, Kubernetes secrets are Base64 encoded, not encrypted, but encoded. And so in order to fully read it as it's supposed to be read, you actually need to decrypt that. And it's also as JSON. So that's why we have the JSON path in here. But the last piece of this is that we will echo out the token that we just created. And so this is my Java Web token that I will use to access the console. So at this point, we are about ready to access the UI. And there are three different ways that you can really do that easily. And I'm going to talk about those now just so you understand how each of them works. So the first way is port forwarding. And that's probably the easiest way because you don't have to do any additional configuration. So use port forwarding at your own risk. It may not work for you. And also note that this is ephemeral. This is temporary. So if you run this kubectl port forward command and forward your address 0000 to the 9090 port on your local machine, you may be able to get temporary access to this. But once you close that console, once this port forward command is not running anymore, then you will lose access to the operator console. So note that that is one way that you could do it, but port forwarding is not the recommended long-term method. The next way that I talked about is to be able to use a node port. So this would be manually created using YAML and the kubectl command. And the node port service would actually allow you to access the operator persistently from outside the cluster. So you would run the kubectl get service console minus n MinIO operator, and then the rest of this, which I'm not going to read for the sake of the transcription. And basically what this gets you is the port or the node port that is used that you can append to your host IP or load balancer IP to access the operator console from your host. So again, you can use this command, and this is a persistent method if you do not have a DNS name and you're not using ingress. The way that we will be using in the demo here is that we defined an ingress in the values.yaml and actually already have DNS pointed at this host. So this should work for us. And the URL that we're going to use here is HTTP. We did not turn on TLS, so this is bare HTTP. TLS is another course that we'll be coming out with if you want to dive deeper into how to integrate certificates into your deployments. But in this case, it's HTTP MinIO console1.dsodemo.org, and that's how we'll access this environment. So here we are at that URL, and because I already pointed my DNS name to this host and the ingress was created on our host when we configured the values file and deployed the MinIO operator, then I can access this page. Now, what it's asking for here is this Java Web token that we gathered at the end of our last lab. So if we come back over here, you can see that this is my Java Web token, and I will copy this whole big string here and simply paste that into here. And now we have logged into the MinIO operator console, and we can begin doing things like configuring tenants. Or if you've already created tenants, then you can modify those tenants or go and check the health of those tenants. So that has been sort of the basic steps to get you going with installing the MinIO operator using Helm. Remember, it's going to be important, depending on the complexity of the environment, to really pay attention to the values in that values file and understand what they do and customize the install to meet your specific requirements and needs for your environment. Again, follow along with the documentation, links in the description, and thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.